I'm Sebastian Davies, a learning experience expert at Dassault Systèmes. Hello, and welcome to this DraftSight for Beginners video on customizing a palette. In this multi-video series, we will develop an architectural drawing. In this video, we will create and customize a palette, adding commands based on existing drawing entities. We'll then use these palette commands to put the finishing touches to a pool and garden border. So, let's get started. We are currently completing a design and need to add some hatch to a pool, then draw some lines to complete the planting border. We will start by freezing the planting layer to better see the border. Landscaping is a common task, so we will create a custom palette with a few commands that we use on a regular basis. First, we right-click and turn on the tool palettes from the contextual menu. There are two default palettes, Draw and Modify, that are in the palette group Create and Modify. We want a new palette and group to make locating our commands easier. To do this, we click Options, Customize Palette. We will then right-click in the palette group and create a new group we will call Landscape, then press Enter to create it. Next, we will right-click in the Palettes panel and click New Palette, assigning a name of Custom and pressing Enter. To add the palette to the group, we drag and drop it and click Close to return to the drawing. We are only interested in our new palette, so we will select Landscape from the Palettes drop-down list. Now we need some commands. There are different ways to add these. We'll start by adding standard commands. Right-click and select Customize Commands. DraftSight has a huge range of command features, so we will use the Find field to type INSER, then right-click on Insert Block and choose Add to Tool Palette. We will then change the Find field to locate the Line command and add it to the tool palette in the same way. With these two commands added, we will click OK to return to the drawing, where we use the Line command and draw a line connecting the two border arcs. When we draw entities, they adopt the currently active layer. In this case, it is layer 0, as we can see by selecting the line and looking at the properties palette. We want the layer to be in landscape, so we will change its properties. In future, we want the palette command to automatically add the line to the landscape layer. One way to do this is to right-click on the line command and select properties. Here, we can set the layer to landscape and the line color to by layer. So if we change the layer line color in the drawing, the command will adopt it. With the changes made, we will click OK and draw another line. We can see that the line is automatically in the layer we want by clicking on it and checking its properties. We often have pools and want to use the same hatch fill by default. We will click on the hatch, then right-click and select Copy to Clipboard. We will then right-click on the palette and click Paste. Pasted entities automatically adopt the properties from the entity, so we will simply rename the command to pool_hatch. Clicking the command automatically calls up the hatch fill with the correct settings. So we will click Specify Points and click in the center of the circle, then press Enter and click OK. Using custom palettes lets our team add commands uniquely relevant to the challenges of our daily tasks and streamline our design process. In our next video, we will look at how to use various drawing tools. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for even more great content and click the link in the description below to access additional tips, tricks, and training courses.